Hi there, I'm excited to show you how to create an amazing double color exposure effect in Photoshop today. This technique is a fantastic way to add a touch of creativity and artistry to your photos, and it is easier than you might think. To get started, the first step is to choose a photo to work with. And don't worry if you don't have one, we have a sample photo provided for this tutorial. Once you have your photo, we will use the select and mask tool to select the subject and output the selection as a layer mask. Now the fun part begins. Double click on the layer to open the layer's blending options. You can uncheck the red channel to make the layer cyan, or untick the green and blue channels to make it red. This is where you can experiment and choose the colors that works best for you. Once you are happy with your choice, simply click OK to move on to the next step. Right. Now it's time to import another photo. You can use the same person or a different one, depending on your preference. For this tutorial, we will be using the same person, but with a different pose. Similar to the first photo, we will use the select and mask tool to select the subject and output the selection as a layer mask. Then we will open the layer blending options and untick the green and blue channels to create a complete opposite color effect for the new layer. Now feel free to use the transform tool, Control or Command plus T to move and place the layer to your liking until you achieve the desired look. Great. Now let's expand this workspace with the crop tool. This will help you create a more focused and visually appealing composition. Background is an essential part of this effect, and we need to add a solid color fill for it. To do this, choose black for the fill color and drag it below all the layers. Changing the background color can also have a significant impact on the overall look of the effect. So let's change the fill color to gray to see how it looks. To make your effect even more unique, you can add another solid color or a gradient for the background. It's totally up to your personal preference and the vision you have for your image. And remember, you have complete control over the position, scale, and color of each layer, so feel free to adjust them to your liking until you achieve the desired look. Okay, good. To get the perfect lighting for your final result, you can adjust the highlights, shadows, and midtones using levels. This will help you achieve a balanced and visually appealing composition that really stands out. If you want to give your image a more natural and organic feel, you can add a touch of noise. To do this, create a new layer and fill it with 50% gray. Then go to the filter menu, select noise, and choose add noise. Keep the amount at 8% and the distribution at Gaussian. Make sure to check the monochromatic box before clicking OK. Next, change the blending mode of the noise layer to overlay. You can also lower the opacity if needed. These small adjustments can really make your image pop and add that extra bit of detail to make it stand out. What's even more incredible is that all the layers you have created so far are non-destructive, meaning you can always go back and make any changes without affecting the other layers. This gives you the flexibility to experiment with different colors, combinations, and effects until you find the perfect look for your image. One additional adjustment layer that you can use to make your image even more unique is the hue and saturation adjustment layer. With this tool, you can adjust the hue slider to change the overall color of the image and increase or decrease the saturation to make the colors more vibrant or muted. It's a great way to play around with different color schemes and make your double exposure stand out even more. That's it for this tutorial, and I'm glad you found this tutorial helpful and enjoyable. And don't forget to give this video a thumbs up if you found it useful, and share it with your friends who might find it helpful too. Lastly, if you want to stay up to date with our latest tutorials, Be sure to subscribe to our channel. We have always strived to provide you with the best and most informative content possible, so you can improve your skills and become a master of Photoshop. Thanks for watching, and I can't wait to see you again in the next video. Take care and happy editing.